Single day. Lord, when you have to stand before me. اِقْتَرَبَ لِلنَّاسِ حِسَابُهُمْ. The time that we have to put forward our records to Allah, it is coming too fast. Allah says, وَأُفِي غَفْلَةِ مُؤْمِنُ. That is the condition of humanity. That's the condition of the human beings on the face of the earth. It's as though they are turning away. It's as though they don't think that they have to stand before Allah. Every single day it's the same exact way, it's deteriorating, very little progress, illa qalila, except for a few people. Otherwise we are sailing one way, we are not increasing. Only towards decrease alone we are headed. Allah says, you have to stand before me, what a cup are you waiting for? When a student, he knows after 5 years of studies, after 8 years of studies, he knows that my final year now, I have to put every single thing in place, because this final exam that I'm going to do, it's going to determine on my certificate what it is I'm going to get a pass, what it is I'm going to get second class honors, what it is I'm going to get first class honors. Your final year determines that. Come on, he motivates himself. He works very, very hard so that distinction can be written. He wants the best because he understands the value of the certificate. Look about our records when we have to present them before Allah. What are we working for? Are we working for distinctions? Do we want firdaus? Are we working for the minimal pass? What are we working for with regards to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The word says, Salat is already going to be established just now. Are you hurrying up to be wuzu to come for Salat? Or are you still playing? Is it that you are performing your sunnah to come for salam? What is it that you have been doing? Azan has already been established. Azan has already been done. What are you waiting on to come for salam? Oh, what is this ever supposed? It's hankering. It's hovering over our heads. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it's from Allah of the Holy Quran. It says, Ya Bani Adam. He says, don't allow shaitan to test you. Don't allow shaitan to beguile you. Don't allow shaitan to fool you. Just as how he had taken your parents out of paradise. Just as how he fooled Hawa alayhi wa salatu wa salam and Adam alayhi wa salatu wa salam. So he fooled them and got them out of paradise. Allah is giving advice to humanity. The poor children of Adam, don't allow shaitan to do it. I understand shaitan is very, very smart. He has been living on the face of the earth for a very long period of time. There isn't a place on the face of the earth that shaitan had not performed such good to Allah. This is the caliber of the individual we are speaking about, shaitan. Allah is saying to humanity, hey, all human beings, O children of Adam, learn from the mistakes of other people. That is part of wisdom. That you understand that this man walked in front of a truck and he was bumped and killed. You don't have to walk in front of a truck to make it bumps. You're going to get killed. You understand and you learn from the wisdom of other people. From the experiences of other people, you learn from it. Allah says to humanity, learn from the experience of your parents that they committed a mistake. Their mistake put them out of paradise. Oh, human beings, don't let shaitan do it to you. But shaitan, he has such an ability. Indeed, he is great. Things of our nafs and our desire, shaitan makes it so appealing to us. Apart from appealing, he makes it so readily available. So easy to access. Very little difficulty goes into accessing it and getting it and performing. And he makes quiet and obedience to Allah so difficult. To sleep at fajr time, because these mornings are making very, very cold, it's very easy. That is very, very easy to do, to take an extra half an hour, to take another hour. To get up and put our hands on face beneath the cold water in the morning, it's hard. It's something that our nafs, we have to shun our nafs to get up for that fajr salat in the morning. Shaitan. know who will see me. One night, first, I'm going to get fired. What's going to happen to me? So easy to leave off salat. How difficult it is to just find 5 minutes to perform 4 rakat salat. 2.5% zakat. You still remain with 97.5% of it. Yes, silly makes 2.5 something so insignificant look so great in our eyes. So hard to give. So difficult to give. When it comes to the obedience of Allah, He makes it look hard. He makes it look difficult. He makes it look as though we cannot do it at all. As long as it's masiyat, as long as it's the disobedience of Allah, it's available. So easy to do. Little effort is needed. Allah says to you, don't allow shaitan to fool you. Don't let him do that at all. Just as how we fool your parents when it is they were in paradise. When it is he fooled Adam alayhi salam, and he fooled Hawa alayhi salatu wa salam, what was the first consequence of the action? The first thing that occurred, rudeness became apparent to both of them. They were able to now see the armor of each other. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in those ayats in Surah Araf, He tells us, understand that clothing that I have been given to you, understand that that's a ni'mat and a favor from Allah. And this clothing that I have given to you, there are different purposes of this clothing. The first purpose of this clothing is to protect us from the elements, from the rain, from the sun. To protect our bodies and to protect our skin, the first purpose of our clothing. And then he says the second purpose of our clothing, Walisha, it is to adorn ourselves, to beautify ourselves. That's why the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he teaches us a beautiful dua. That whenever we adorn ourselves with new garments and new clothing, that we ought to say, Alhamdulillah illahi, that all praise is due to Allah, who is that one. Kasani, who has clothed me, Waribihi Amrati, He has made my awrah covered now. What a jammalu bihi fi hayati. And now He has adorned me and made me handsome in this goodly life. Clothing of favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ni'mat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In these times that we live in, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, purpose of clothing, it is to cover the awrah of the body. And in our sharia, every individual knows the awrah of his body. He says, that's the purpose of your clothing, to cover yourselves, to adorn yourselves, to beautify yourselves, but make sure that your awrah is totally covered. Do that, that's the purpose of your clothing. Understand? Although you recognize the purpose of clothing, shaitan is going to beguile you now. He's going to fool you now. He's going to cause it to become so readily available in front of your eyes that you are going to fall towards lust, you are going to fall towards your beastly side. Allah mentioned, by the presence of sins around us and us shunning it, it is an avenue. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has opened up a way in which we can raise in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By a man now, knowing that these things are around him, he can now say that, no, I am not going towards that. I prefer to go towards the obedience of Allah instead. Your heart is going to ache for a few seconds, but the multitude of thawab and rewards you get from Allah is phenomenal. Shun it, push it aside. Allah says, I'm going to reward you. I'm going to give it to you. I think he wants to live. In the time of Ayyah, son of the long time, he says towards his ministers, he says, I have 80 rubies, I have 80 emeralds with me. I would like that you destroy every single one of them, he tells the ministers. The ministers then says to him, okay, this is something valuable. We can't just destroy something that's valuable just like that. The king says, okay. He says, all I ask to be, I want to speak to him. I ask the great wali of Allah comes. The king says, I have this valuable rubies with me. Destroy them for me, please. ministers and midayas and says, how can you do such a thing? Something so rash, something so big, something so huge, how come you can do that? Ayah says, he says, when it is you love something, when your heart is filled with love for something, then it doesn't matter who say or what our intelligence is, we do that particular thing. He says, the order of the king is more beloved to me than my own intelligence and my own intellect. So therefore, I prefer to obey the king and destroy every single one of these rubies rather than to obey my intellect and obey my intelligence. Ulama, with regards to the story mentioned, if it is we had the same love for Allah in our hearts, then all our intellects, all our nafs will be pulling us towards ma'asiyat and sins, because we love Allah, His divine law will take precedence and take preference. Therefore, people, it forced upon them, think for a few minutes, who do we really love? Is our hearts filled with Allah, or is our hearts filled with something else? What is our hearts really filled with? Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions, إِنَّ مِنَ شَرَاتِ السَّاعَةِ, certainly from amongst the signs of the Day of Judgment, he says, أَيُّ الْفَارِلِ, he says, knowledge is going to be taken away. Knowledge is going to be taken away because of the ulama. Ulama, they are going to start to die, they are going to start to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. While our libraries are becoming bigger, while our hard drives with books are becoming phenomenally large, yet still the amount of knowledge present with people is so little. What is really ill? Ill is ma'yu ad-deen al-amal. Ill is that thing that pushes you toward doing al-amal saliha. How much of that is with our humanity today? How much ill is really there? A lot of libraries and a lot of books, but how much ill is really in the hearts of the human beings today? Allah says that this thing is going to be taken up. Ilm is going to be taken up. When knowledge is taken up, what then is going to happen to the face of the earth? وَيُبْثَرُ الْجَهْلُ, Nabi says, jahl, total ignorance is going to start to come up. Haven't we seen it? With regards to what our young kids, we tell them, hey, don't lie, don't steal, dress better than that. We encourage them when it is they are small. All of these things go on. Today we see it happening upon our streets, yet still that same man who a few years ago was telling his children, don't do that, that's wrong. Now if it is, you want to go on the street and say it, everybody thinks he's a man. How it is you can stop a man from consuming alcohol? How come you can stop people from dressing like this? We have freedom. We can do all that we want. Today our minds are so warped that things one day which we would think was so abominable has now become so acceptable and readily acceptable to us. We don't even give a second thought towards it again. Jahl, ignorance will start to spread. He says, fornication is going to start to run rampant. He says, the consumption of alcohol is going to become readily available. All of these things are going to start to happen. When it is, it comes towards the signs of the Day of Judgment, everybody likes to hear it. People love to hear about that child. People love to hear about when the sun rises from the west. People that are inclined towards all of the different signs of the Day of Judgment, lectures and then people will flock to it. They love to hear these different things. These things, when it is we hear, it should bring joy to our hearts. Rather, our hearts should be palpitating because of fear of Allah. It's supposed to point us in the direction I need to change my life. Qiyamah is coming soon. It's not just a fairy tale, and it's not just a story. It's not just something that we have to just hear. Okay, we leave our houses now. We leave the masjid and we go back now. It's supposed to cause a change in our lives when we hear about signs of the Day of Judgment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after telling us, after informing us and giving us that was and giving us that advice, that shaitan is going to try to get us. He's going to try to fool us just as we fool our parents. Nabi says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, he says, وَلِبَاسُ التَّقْوَى ذَلِكَ الْخَيْرُ, he says, adorn yourselves with the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. says that is far better for you. Adorn ourselves with the recognition of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Adorn ourselves with the ma'rifat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So while we recognize that we are in a state now, that we really can't do anything about the walking upon the streets, what then is a Muslim to do now? One, the first thing that he has to do is anything connected to it, he save himself from it. That's the first thing. Tawbul ma'asi. Leave off sins. Stop it, both you as an individual. Make sure that you don't go towards sins. And the second thing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Hud, he says, Inna al-hasanat. And certainly the doing of hasanat and the doing of good deeds, you the him and the sayyat, is going to push away, it's going to shun sayyat, it's going to shun away sin. But it is we make an intention now to do something good with our lives. Let us be mukhlis and let us be sincere in whatever we do. Let us be sincere to Allah that, oh Allah, I really want to change my life for your sake. Be sincere to Allah. Secondly, if it is you do anything for anybody, you do a person a kindness. Don't do it because you are doing it in order to get some material benefit from him. Do it honestly from your heart that I am doing this for my because I love this individual. You be sincere with one another. Be sincere with Allah. Be sincere with one another. When you tell somebody, Assalamu alaikum, mean what you say. Really mean what you say. Not that I hope you're dead. Let it not just be a kalam from our mouths. Let it be something that permeates from our hearts. I really love you. You are really safe from me. I'm not going to backbite you. I'm not going to slander you. Your wealth is safe from me. Your honor is safe with me. And let us be sincere with ourselves as well. But sometimes, apparently, we seem to be so good picky and so pious. Just in white with long gowns. But people who actually know us know that we are far from what it is we show, apparently. Let us be sincere with ourselves that we want to actually make a change for betterment. I want to be a better individual in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as I conclude the one narration from the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Says whosoever fears, he stands out early. Woman ad leja balagh al manzila. And he says, whosoever stands out early, he will reach towards his destination. The Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said this to the Arabs. Because in those days, there were certain robbers on different streets. They used to come out in the morning time. So the only time if it is you had to travel, you had to leave very, very early in the night and make sure that you are at your place and your destination before those robbers actually come out. So he says, man khafa, whosoever fears these robbers, adlajad, make sure to leave your houses early. Woman adlajad, if you leave your house early and you go on your destination, balaghal manzila, you are going to reach to your destination safely. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, he says, certainly the provisions with Allah, those things that belong to Allah, they are expensive. In the silhat Allah, certainly that provision that the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is speaking about, it is paradise. Paradise is not cheap. We need to do some sort of effort with it. A man knows that he has to build a house. In his mind, he sets a target and he sets a goal. That this one job that I have is not sufficient. I need to get three if it is I want the house. He sets a goal in his mind that after 10 years, this is where I am supposed to reach. Because he knows this is what he wants to achieve. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, if it is we want to achieve Jannah, understand that Jannah, it is money, it is expensive. We need to do something in order to gain and attain that paradise. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says to the Arabs, he says, if it is you want to get to your destination safely, you need to leave early. Indeed, we are already standing up to come for Salat. Azan has already been called. The decision is for you and I now. Do we want to come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and let us have that Jannah easy? Or is it that we want to rush towards that Jannah? Or is it that we want to have to do a lot of work in the latter part of our years? Indeed, the thing is that we don't know when that is going to come to us. We don't know if the Imam would have Allah said is when you stand up for salat before we actually anticipate salat. When is that salatul janazah going to be read for you and I? Maybe we need to make a change in our lives. Especially these times in which we are living in. Tarukul ma'asi, leave out all sins. And the other one is Allah says, Innal hasanat yudhibun as-sayyiat, bringing good qualities into our lives. We open pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he blesses us. He protects us. He accepts us for the fitment of his deen. We open pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gives us a personal fatima, he gives us a good ending. I hope and pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he accepts us and he blesses us, and he allows us to live with Iman, die with Iman, and rise under the judgment of Bufiq Iman. Wa'afir.